As we start combining many lines of code into scripts or functions, there are more opportunities to introduce mistakes. Sometimes our code will result in an error message. Or it may produce an output that is different than we expect. Oops! Such errors are often called bugs. We can locate mistakes and fix errors using the debugger in MATLAB. Let's see how using this example. This code is meant to calculate the total account balance and interest earned on a vector of deposits and interest rates for each year. However, when we run the code, we receive an error message. There was a problem in line 7 of the code related to multiplication, as referenced in the error message. To help determine the cause of the error, let's run the code again, but this time, pause the execution of the code at the line where the error occurs. We do this using a breakpoint. With the code file open in the MATLAB editor, let's create a breakpoint by left-clicking on the dash next to line 7. A red circle is displayed on the line number indicating that we have set a breakpoint. Now, when we run the file, the command prompt changes to show us that we are in debug mode. And new buttons are available in the MATLAB editor toolstrip. We also see the current values of variables in the workspace. Notice that the loop variable I is 1. And variable interest is 0 because the code was stopped before line 7 was executed. We have two options for continuing code execution. We could use the Continue button to resume execution until another breakpoint is reached, an error occurs, or the code runs to completion. Or we can use the Step button to execute only the current line of code, which is indicated by the green arrow. Since we don't know where the error is, let's use the Step button to execute line 7 and advance the code one line. The variable interest is updated and we see it is a vector of 6 elements. We meant for interest to be a scalar value, so it looks like we might have found our error. In debug mode, we can type commands to test possible corrections. Here, what we meant to do was use the loop variable I to select a value from the vector rates. Since we found the error, let's press the Quit Debugging button. Then, update and save the code file. It's important to quit debugging because we can't save our changes in debug mode. Notice the breakpoint wasn't removed, and execution will pause here next time the code is run. To run the code without stopping, we remove the breakpoint by left-clicking on it. Now, let's run the code and... oops! Another error. Do you see where the error is? If not, try using the debug tools to find and fix the mistake. Set a breakpoint and step or continue through the code until you find the error. Pay attention to the dimensions of variables as the code iterates through the for loop.